A glimpse of Starlings. I expect him any minute now, although he's dead. I know he has been talking all night to his own dead, and now, in the first heartbreaking light of morning, he is struggling into his clothes, sipping a cup of tea, fingering a bit of bread, eating a small photograph with his eyes. The questions bang and rattle in his head like doors and canisters the night of a storm. He doesn't know why his day's finished like this. Daylight is as hard to swallow as food. Love is a crumb all of him hungers for. I can hear the drag of his feet on the concrete path, the close explosion of his smoker's cough, the slow turn of the Yale key in the lock, the door opening to let him in to what looks like release from what feels like pain, and over his shoulder a glimpse of Starlings suddenly lifted over field, road, and river like a fist of black dust pitched in the wind.